Now I request Sri Rahul Gandhiji to please come and address the HAL employees and former employees and Air Force people from here. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, all of. Thank you to all of the people who have come here, senior leaders, and the people who spoke. In this type of a meeting, unfortunately, only 5 or 6 people can speak, so everybody does not have a chance. Many people want to say what is in their heart, but the time is limited. So I apologize to all of you who would have liked to speak, but couldn't speak, and I think you are one of those people. There are a couple questions that you have raised. Two lines stuck in my mind. Number one is that these are the temples of modern India. And what is happening is that the temple of modern India are being attacked and destroyed. And we cannot allow, by we I mean you and all of us, cannot allow the temples of modern India to be destroyed. It is not going to be allowed. The second point someone raised, sorry? Determination. And second point someone raised, that you have worked now for 70 years. If somebody thinks that they can build their future on top of your graves, that is also not going to be allowed. It cannot be that you have spent 70 years working, developing all this capability. We can see all these advanced light helicopter, we can see Tejas, we can see all these aircraft that you built. It cannot be that this is not worth anything. There is tremendous amount of experience that you have, and this cannot just be destroyed or wiped out in this manner. So I want to make it very clear to you. I know you are fighting for this, but realize that we are also going to fight for it. We are not going to allow it. Now, I've not come here to give a political speech or have a political meeting. But I do want to point out one thing, which somebody else said. Somebody said that a very senior person in the government has said that HAL does not have a, what is the exact wording used? Capability? It does not have the capacity. Well, what about the person who got the contract? What capacity does he have? Right? So, I can see HAL's capacity here. I can see all these pictures here. I can see Sukhoi. I can see Chetak. I can see all these things. This is your capacity. I can see 70 years of your work. 78, 75, 78 years of your work. I can see, I remember when I was small, everybody used to talk about the NAT aircraft that defeated the F-100 aircraft, Sabre aircraft. This is common knowledge. Who gave it? HAL gave it. So you have a history, you have an experience, you have carried out this work for the country. And I understand deeply that you are pained, and I understand deeply that you are hurt. And this is as important to me as any corruption or any other thing that has happened, that people who have given their life, people who have stood by this country, are feeling emotionally upset because they have been insulted. So I know the government is not going to apologize, but on their behalf, I apologize to you. Even though I have nothing to do with it, I understand that you are hurt, and I want to stand with you in your discomfort. What is the experience exactly that the person who got the contract has? Your company has been there 78 years. Their company, his company has been here, been there 10 days. 10 days. Does HAL have any debt on it? No. Zero. In fact, I believe the government has taken 5,000 crores from you. Right? The person who has supposedly got experience has 45,000 crore rupees debt. So, it is completely ridiculous that they can say that HAL does not have experience. And even if they make that statement, then certainly the person who has got the contract has zero experience, not even 1% experience. They have never built a plane. So, I wanted to commit to you here that the public sector is the backbone of this country. It is the backbone of Bangalore. It is the backbone of the defense forces. And I'm not just talking about HAL. I'm talking about ISRO. I'm talking about NAL. I'm talking about HAL. I'm talking about DRDO. All these industries, companies that work together to make sure that India is protected, that allow us to feel comfortable, that allow us to sleep comfortably at night. I want to, through you, give them a message that we are going to protect your future. And we are going to fight for your right. This Rafael contract is your right. You are the only company in this country that has the experience to build that plane. And this type of thing should be done on merit. One should clearly look, what is merit? Does HAL have merit? Has HAL got capability? Or does this other gentleman have merit? Make a clear, objective decision based on merit, and nobody in the world, if he is acting objectively and if he is acting clearly on merit, nobody in the world can give the contract away from HAL. It cannot be done. Logically. And the whole country understands this. You know, you said that you have invited me here and you are speaking to me because if you say it, media will not listen. But I must tell you, media does not listen to us also these days. You know, look, they're laughing over there, but it's true. These people, they want to listen to us, but the people on top of them, they don't want. Their bosses don't want this type of a conversation to be heard. That is the truth of India today. But you are the people who spend your lives working. You are the people who work with your hands. You are the people, this Tejas plane here, you are the people who built it. How can someone say that people who have built this plane have no experience? You know, so I stand with you 100%. If ever you want to speak to me about your issues, if ever you need my support, if ever anybody else in the defense public sector companies wants to tell me anything, wants me to help them on anything, wants me to raise any issue, 24/7, I salute you, I am ready to do it for you. 24/7. You can wake me up at 5 in the morning, 4 in the morning and say, look, DRDO has a problem, HAL has a problem, please come to HAL and raise our issue, I will be available for you. This is not going to be, let me tell you, it's not going to be easy. Because the forces that are trying to take away your future, all public sector, all defense related units, they are quite powerful and they are quite connected. So it's not going to happen just with one speech. It is going to happen by building a relationship between you and us, by us knowing exactly what is concerning you, by us knowing exactly what is disturbing you, and by you being able to have a free conversation with us. That was the spirit of me coming here. I don't want to raise over here issues of corruption and stuff. There is another place to raise that, and I am raising that. But here I have purposely only spoken about HAL, the merit, and of course a lot of people have not been allowed to come from there, and I understand that the management might be under pressure, I understand that, but this is a message for them also, that we are speaking for you also, even though you are being pressurized, we are speaking for you, and we fundamentally believe that India's defense preparedness can only be safe if companies like HAL, DRDO, NAL are safe and protected. So I would like to again thank you all. I'd like to thank Siddaramaiah ji, Reddy ji, Venugopal ji, Parmeshwar ji, PCC president, and all of you who have come here, all the people who have spoken. With all my heart, like to thank you very much. Namaskar.
Sir, please be seated. Sir, the Vajra group of employees who are from the HAL want to give you a memorandum. They have been in the forefront of raising issues. Please be seated. Please be seated.
We are asking orders. I don't know what the cost is, why the cost is. We give the orders, we'll give the job. We'll get it completed. Because even Hawk, what it was given to us, we have completed cycle time, what we have given to us.